let's have a look at type 2. When I say about type 1, you have about Z parameters. Whenever you hear about a word about Z parameter, you should first recollect about voltages. The equation you had V1, V2, V1 in terms of I1, I2, V2 in terms of I1, I2. That should be there in your mind whenever you hear about Z parameters. It is like here. Type 2, it's all about transmission parameters, or you can say about ABCD parameters. When I hear about a word about transmission parameters or ABCD parameters, the first thing should come to your mind is your equation should be in terms of input. The first thing should come to your mind is that the equation should be in terms of input. You have four parameters. 1, 2, 3, 4. V1, V2, I1, I2. Four parameters. V1, V2, I1, I2. When I say about only input, that means I have V1 and I1. That means my equation should be in terms of input. That means it should be in terms of V1, I1. So it should be V1 equal to I1 equal to. So you only think, what is remaining? So remaining is V2, I2. So V1 will be in terms of V2, I2. I1 will be in terms of V2, I2. That should be the logic, the way you should remember about it. Again, let's revise. Four parameters. V1, V2, I1, I2. When I say about transmission parameters, when I say about ABCD parameters, the equation should be in terms of input. So you have V1 and I1. So the equation should be V1 equal to I1 equal to. So V1 should be equal to in terms of V2 and I2. I1 should be equal to in terms of V2 and I2. In Z parameters, you had minus plus sign. In ABCD or transmission parameters, you have minus sign. So that was a brief about ABCD and transmission. Let's have a look at a detail about how to solve ABCD parameters. To solve an ABCD parameters, guys, just trust me, you have to go again to Z parameters. That's the simplest form. So whenever it is asked ABCD parameters or transmission parameters, please solve your Z parameters once again. That's it. After getting Z parameters, your sum will be very easy. I believe you guys have solved Z parameters type 1 and type 2. If not, please don't start this topic unless and until you have solved your Z parameters. So your Z parameters should be very thorough. So let's have a look, guys. I said when it is asked ABCD and transmission parameters, you should think about Z parameters. So plus minus V1, plus minus V2, current enters I1, I2, clockwise direction. Going very fast, because assuming you have done type 1, type 2. Apply KVL, apply KVL, apply KVL. The equation you got from mesh 2. The reason of solving this is that I need I1 in terms of I3 in terms of I1 and I2. Because your V2 was in terms of I2 and I3. Your V1 was in terms of I1 and I3. Because I don't need I3. I don't need I3. The reason is that I need I3 in terms of I1, I2 or combination of I1, I2. So for that, I had to find the equation of I3. So now put this equation in equation A and B. So that your V1 will be in terms of I1, I2. V2 will be in terms of I1, I2. So that you get your Z parameter. So your solving your V1, you got it. So in V1 equation, you have put the value of I3. Simplify it. So you got the equation of Z parameter, first equation. V2, you have put the value of I3. Simplify it. Get only one term. So you got the equation of second equation of Z parameters. The question didn't say that you have to solve Z parameter, but question said to find the value for transmission and all ABCD parameters. Now let's have a look. For transmission, let's revise once again. There are four parameters. V1, very good. V2, next. I1, very nice. Next, I2. Select the input. So you are seeing, very nice. V1 and I1. So what is remaining? Perfect. V2, I2. So V1 will be in terms of V2, I2. I1 will be in terms of V2, I2. V1, I1 input. Remaining is V2, I2, V2, I2. Sign will be minus. Very nice. In Z parameters, plus. So it will be A, B, C. That is it. So I have equation of V1 in terms of V2, I2. Equation of I1 in terms of V2, I2. Now let's have a look. How to get Z ABCD parameter? As I said, if you do Z parameters, your 90% of the sum is over. So just need small verification or modification to get ABCD parameters. Now let's have a look. So I1 in terms of V2, I2. My dear friends, observe the second equation of Z parameters. If I keep I1 only over here and shift I to this side, that means I will get I1 in terms of V2 and I2. That means I will get the second equation of ABCD. So to get a second equation of ABCD, I need to get it from second equation of Z parameters. You have to learn this. To get second equation of ABCD, I need to solve the second equation of Z parameters. Okay? So now let's solve. So I'll modify the second equation. I've kept I1 over here, shift that side. Shift, this will be 5/4. Again over here, 5/4, simplified. You got I1. So you got I1 in terms of V2. That means you got the second equation for ABCD. That means this is nothing but your C. This is your D. So your C is 5/4, your D is 6/4. Now let's have a look. Now, to get this first equation. First equation of what? ABCD. Now, your first equation you will get from Z parameter. But, your Z parameter equation is this. V1 equal to I1, I2. But you don't need I1, I2. Your V1 should be in terms of V2, I2. So, you have to remove I1. I1 should be in terms of Yato V2. Or I2 or V2 and I2. So, do I have equation of I1 in terms of V2 or I2 or V2 I2? Yes, I have got the second equation of ABCD. I1 is in terms of V2 and I2. So, put this equation, my dear friends, over here. So, I put this equation of I1 over here. Simplify it, this equation. So, I'll get the V1 in terms of V2 and I2. This will be my first equation of ABCD. So, coefficient of V2 will be A, coefficient of I2 will be B. So, I got the value for ABCD. Again, let's revise, my dear friends. Whenever it is asked, ABCD parameters, what you will be solving? Correct, Z prime parameter. After getting Z parameters, I got Z parameters V1 and V2 in terms of voltage. V1 in terms of I1, I2. V2 in terms of I1, I2. My ultimately goal is that I need to find ABCD parameters. I have 4 parameters. V1, V2, I1, I2. Select input. So V1 and I1. So V1 equal to, I1 equal to. So V1 will be in terms of, remaining part is V2, I2. So V2, I2. I1 will be in terms of V2, I2. Sign will be minus. Where will it be plus? It will be in Z parameters. So about A, B, C. If after obtaining Z parameters, let's get ABCD parameters. Remember the steps. From second equation of Z parameters, you'll get the second equation for ABCD. And from first equation of Z parameters, you'll get the first equation of ABCD. How? By putting the second equation of ABCD in first equation of Z parameters, you'll get the first equation for ABCD. Again, repeating the same thing. From second equation of Z parameters, you will get the second equation for ABCD just by modifying it, shifting it. And what about this first equation? From first equation of Z parameters, you need to put the second equation of Z parameter into first equation. First equation of Z parameters, put second equation of the ABCD parameters to get first equation of ABCD parameters. So that's the basic logic, guys. Put all the values of ABCD, that's it. So let's learn the how to put the namings for it. How to put the values and sign convention for it. So let's move further. So after getting all the values of ABCD, my dear friends, put the all the values for A, B, and C and D. Now next question arises, what should be the unit? In previous case, my dear friend, when we were doing type 1, since all the terms were Z, so the impedance unit was ohms. But in this case, what is A, what is B, what is C, what is D? Let's see, find out, let's see what is the unit for ABCD. For ABCD, my dear friends, let's write the equation for ABCD. So this is the equation for ABCD in terms of input. So remaining terms is V2, I2, V2, I2, minus sign ABC. For finding A unit, guys, I need to put the value for B0. So this whole part is gone. So A will be V1 upon V2. So voltage upon voltage, that means no unit. Volts upon volt, it will get cancelled. So A will not have any unit, it will be unitless. Let's find for B, my dear friends. For B, I need to put A as 0. Don't care about minus plus sign. So this is 0, my dear friends. So B will be voltage upon current. Voltage upon current is nothing but ohms. What about C, my dear friend? If I need to find C, I need to put D as 0. This whole part is 0. So it will be current upon voltage. The current upon voltage will be the inverse of impedance. That means it will be ohm. What about D, my dear friends? Your C will be 0. The whole part will be 0. This will be current upon current. So again, this will be no unit. That means in above case, for ABCD, if I need to put the unit, my A, I have no unit, B, ohms, C, it is more, D, again it is unitless. Because if you don't put the units, guys, straight away your 2 marks will be deducted. So you need to know the unit as well. Thank you so much. I hope you enjoyed it. Let's take one more example on ABCD parameters in terms of dependent sources. I hope you guys remember what is dependent sources. If not, please go and revise your mesh analysis. Thank you so much. Signing off.